Hey guys, it's me back again with another reaction video on this channel. Today is Vecchi Mecchi's comeback, I guess. Tiki Taka, 99%. I don't know why 99%, to be honest, but yeah. This is, I guess, the title track for the repackaged album, Weekend. Weekend Low? I don't know. I'm not that into Vecchi Mecchi yet. I know Crush. I wasn't like super hyped about Crush, but I started to like it more and more over the months. I listened to it a few more times, but I recently got into them a bit because of Picky Picky, because I really really like that song. It's so cool. It's such a cool video. I don't know, the song structure is, I think, the most important, the best thing about that song to me personally. I just really liked how they started off the song. They just, with this after chorus, basically, they started the song with the after chorus, then went into the first part, then the chorus, and then the after chorus again. So it was really cool structure. I never really saw anything like that so far in K-pop, and basically in music in general. It was really cool. I kind of had to get a bit... Like, I needed a bit time to get used to the chorus, like, I guess 20 listens or so, but it got better for sure. It's growing on me, or it grew on me. But everything else, especially the after chorus, I really liked. Also the video, and yeah, just them having fun and stuff like that. I really liked the choreo too. So yeah, that's it about what I like and know about Vecchi Mecchi. Yeah, before I start this video, if you like my reaction, then please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel. It helps me a lot in just doing what I do and keep growing and do more stuff and stuff like that. I have a lot of reactions on my channel to K-pop and also Korean hip-hop. I do that from time to time, depends on what is coming out, but usually there's a lot of stuff coming out in Korean hip-hop. Kinda comparable to K-pop, actually. But yeah, anyways. You can check it out for yourself on my channel if you want. So yeah, here we go. It has English subtitles. Tiki Taka. It's a interesting name. Like I don't know what to expect. So far, it looks kind of Latin vibe from the styles and looks. It reminds me of Latata from Idol, kinda. Like the outfits and stuff like that. Kind of a little bit reminds me of that. Oh. And this reminds me of two things, both Mamamoo related. One is You're the Best, I think, or something like that. I always forget the song title from all the songs. I think it's You're the Best, alright. Anyways, also from Gogo Bebe, these like chairs they're laying in. So cool. Also, this scene is very interesting. So much stuff going on. Oh yeah, I would like consider Vecchi Mecchi not really being a girl crush concept from what they usually do, but also not a cute concept. I think they're under a new like group of concepts. I personally at least call it a new group, and I call it fun concept. And I think another group that really, really fits to that concept, not just with their recent comeback, but just with their regular music, is Promise 9. Also Nature, maybe. Okay, I have to kind of repeat a bit here. I was talking too much, sorry. The visuals, though. Ooh, interesting start of the chorus. It's very party and summery vibe. Like, it's almost end of summer, guys. You're a bit late, but I'm taking it. Oof. See what I mean? It's so fun. Ooh. Tiki Tiki Taka. We're 99. Is it like the birth year? For most members? I don't know. Oh no, 99%. Okay, makes sense now from the song title, but what does it mean? Is it what I was guessing from the birth, like, the year where they were born? But I don't think so, right? Makes not that much sense. Let's go. the smiley faces. Oh, I really like her eyes. Like, I think she was the one in Picky Picky that had like the platinum blonde and pink hair, like these colors like mixed, or not really mixed, but she had both hair colors together, you know what I mean? Like half-half, kind of. I think that's her, right? The one where in the first chorus all are pointing at her, that she was the one to blame. I think it's her too, because her eyes there also stuck out a lot. Like, it's crazy. Like, there's so much you can see in her eyes. I'm not sure if it's context right now or not. Really don't, no idea. I'm really bad in seeing if it's context. But, damn, she has such, like, these eyes just look into your soul, like, it's crazy. Yeah, but it's really a fun concept, right? It's not really a cute concept, I mean, it's cute, but it's not only cute, it's also sexy and elegant and just bubbly. So, I guess fun concept is a good word. I really like the scene with them in the pool. Looks so funny. Ooh, chorus. The chorus is so unexpected all the time, cause there's no real build-up and no drop or anything like that. They're just going straight into chorus. Interesting. And I think the second part of the chorus just didn't exist this time, right? I think it was the first time there was a second part where they were dancing like this. Kinda. I'm bad, sorry. But now they didn't have that. It's interesting. They just cut the chorus short for the third part. Maybe a bridge now? No, it's the third part. Also, there's not really a rap part in the song, which is interesting. Like, I haven't heard any K-pop songs the past years or so where there's at least not a single rap part. Especially for girl groups, they kinda want to do everything to please the most people, right? Because girl groups usually sell way less albums than boy groups, so they kinda have to come up with even more ideas and stuff to promote themselves, kinda. And there's always a few people, like me personally, who like rap parts in K-pop and just rap in general as a music style, so they kinda want to please these people. But I don't really think there's a rap part here. I think there was not really a rap part in Picky Picky too. Like, there was one, I think, in the bus in the middle of the song, but it wasn't really a heavy rap part or something like that. It was more a sing rap. I think there was one here too in the first part, maybe. I kind of thought about it when it played, that this is maybe the rap part of the song, but they don't really have a straight up rap part. It's interesting. It's so different. Ooh, the background vocal. If you guys know who did that background vocal, like here into the entrance of the third chorus, then please tell me. I really like background vocals, and her high note was really good. Like, here. Damn. This is so fun to watch this video. Like, the last time I had so much fun watching a music video in K-pop was Famous 9 Fun. And before that, probably Wacky Micky Picky Picky, so... Tiki-taka! It just makes you smile. Actually, there was one song where I had to smile all the time too, but it wasn't really K-pop, it's from Shaman and Money, the current season. A performance of a female rapper there. I think Yuju was her name. I'm not quite sure, but I think she dropped out. Like, she got eliminated, I think, in the fourth episode. But she had a really cool stage. It was so cute, and you just had to smile all the time. And this is kind of the same. Also, I think maybe Heartfelt, the song Heartfelt, featuring Moonbyul from Mamamoo. Happy Now, I think, was the song title name. That song also was kind of like that, that I had to smile all the time. But, like, really, really, it was the last time, it's ending, was Famous 9 Fun. And before that, Wiki, Mickey, Picky, Picky. What is going on? Where is the sound coming from? Birds? Oh, there's radio there. But what's the story behind this? I'm confused. She's mad. That was a cool ending. Like, what? What's going on? Okay, man. I like Wiki Mickey more and more. Like, it was just played in the background again. I guess. I just like them more and more. I don't know. The song structure is so interesting and so different from like everything in K-pop right now. Like, actually, this song structure is not that different. Okay, let's phrase it otherwise. This is not that shocking as maybe Picky Picky was, with beginning the song with the after chorus, right? But here, the second chorus was just cut short, and they made the song structure so interesting with that. I don't know, it's very interesting to listen to the song just because of that. It's just very different and it's something new. You're just very curious to listen to the song. This chorus too is so fun, so enjoyable. Oh, it's so catchy too. Oof. I really enjoy listening to the song, to be honest. It's not annoying at all. Like, I don't know what it is with some people that hate on Farmers 9 and Wiki Mickey for the song being too cute and stuff like that. I actually heard a lot of people saying that in my from my friends, because they're not really into girl groups because they're all female and mostly are into boy groups. Except maybe some exceptions from, let's say, Mamamoo. Most are listening to Mamamoo. But anyways, they just don't really like Farmers 9, also Momoland and Wiki Mickey for their cute concept, they call it. But I don't really think it's a cute concept. I think it's just a fun concept and it's very interesting songs and stuff to listen to. Like, the song is so good too. I don't know why you would never like this song. Like, I can't see myself ever hating this. It's so good. Like, there's so much cute concept songs from girl groups, also boy groups though, but that I just don't like at all. Like, so not good for me personally. But like, this is nothing like that for me. It's so different. Like, I just really... Wow, the song's almost over again. Crazy. I just really, really like Wiki Mickey, Girls in the Park, and Farmers 9 for their kind of new take on music. I don't know. I think these three groups are the best example for that. It's just very, very different, and I really like it. So, yeah. That's it for me, guys. Please support the song and Wiki Mickey. Please, please, please. Stream it all day, every day. And also, you can support me the same way if you want. Check out my other videos on my channel. As I said earlier, like this video if you like my reaction. And subscribe to my channel if you want. And yeah, I'm doing a lot of reactions, like one every day. Sometimes more, but mostly one each day. I'm focusing on comics for sure, but I do requests too. There's a long list of stuff I have to react to, but the more a certain song or group gets requested, the higher the chance that I will react to it earlier, you know? I'm kind of like having a priority list in my request stuff. So yeah, just stuff that gets more requested I listen to first, obviously. So yeah, that's it from me. Have a nice day, guys. See you in the next video and goodbye.